them. I have defeated the devil.
Master Lucifer, I acknowledge you as my God and Prince, and I promise to serve you and obey your will for as long as I shall live. And if I ever fail to serve you and adore you, and if I fail to honor you thrice a day, I give up my life to your benefit.
In evil, one basically seeks to elevate their god, the chosen deity. The concept of Satanism does not really appear before the annals of the Inquisition, when it conducted tortures, confessions under pressure, and all sorts of vexations. It is then when we start to have a written document, a historical record of what Satanists must do. From that point on, to someone who wants to become a Satanist, it is very easy to know how to do it, simply because there is a manual book.
In medieval Spain, Christian blood was an important and differential quality. According to the Inquisition, headed by Torquemada, the Moors and the Jews had impure blood, and there was a marked mistrust towards converts. Old cults, religions, and myths, which represented an array of different customs and traditions, meant the constant presence of the enemy. Within these walls, a life always dark, reserved, and incorruptible to the eyes of everybody. It was created to be the most efficient machine of political and religious oppression in history. As much as the presence of the devil was a constant, a malicious character expelled to hell, it also allowed a challenge to fight within mankind in order to defeat their weaknesses. As always, good and evil develop the bloodiest battle. If anyone was to represent the highest form of the devil to the inquisitors, that was the woman. She was the perfect tool that the demon could count on to deceive men. His first task was to mislead her towards his side. The rest was easy. Men would inevitably fall into her clutches. With his pictures of the witch's Sabbath and the presence of the devil, as well as Bosch and his Renaissance aesthetic of the Garden of Delights, represented the perdition of mankind, showing their lowest instincts. The symbols of damnation appear less fierce, but nonetheless with a tendency completely satanic.
Thank you. The Inquisition, in my opinion, marks a turning point of what we call Satanism. Before the Inquisition, before the witch trials, it was difficult to refer to Satanism and even less to organize Satanism. There was not a real concept, a real notion of devotion to the manifest, the devil, but really strange parallel cults. On one hand, logic enough, we think that Christianity was very oppressed towards women. It neglected their sexuality, her access to pleasure. On the other hand, existed the other cult, the cult to nature, to life, to sexuality, to fertility, happiness, that gave her several options. It would even grant her the possibility to become priestess. In a way, some women, the most liberal, seemed to follow that path, and those were considered witches.
In the world of sects, particularly the satanic ones, remaining anonymous, Manuel Carbajal, a research journalist, has successfully brought to public light the most forbidden issues. Camouflaged, he has been able to infiltrate several sects and can tell of his experiences.
This book is one instance of one of the Spanish satanic sects located on the Canary Island, Ocinata Sotoluc, which gives it to its members a book full of blasphemies against Christianity, Islam, Jesus, and Mohammed. According to the Spanish Scientific Police Brigade, each page is handwritten with blood for each adept of this satanic sect. This book is one of the products that Ocinata Sotoluc circulates using a distributor of blasphemous products, in which we can find astonishing works such as images of crucified Jesus with a pork head, lamb head, images of Virgin Mary with penis, banners, t-shirts. It even produces musical piece, black metal, trash metal, with apologetic lyrics of the anti-Christianity.